So let's talk about transference in psychology. Transference in psychology is a redirection or projection of the feelings a person has or had about his parents on other people, like partners, friends, boss at work. It usually concerns feelings from a primary relationship during childhood. Transference first was described by Sigmund Freud, and Sigmund Freud is the founder of psychoanalysis. And Sigmund Freud is considered to be one of the founders of the science of psychology. Transference happens when words, actions, and even appearance of the person remind us somehow our childhood. And this can be our partners, our friends, our children, or even strangers on the street. When something about them, the way they talk, the way they walk, the way they look, the way they dress, reminds us our childhood, our parents, we have transference. So we transfer our feelings into them. We transfer our old pain, our old expectations that we had towards our parents, we transfer to other people who have nothing to do with that. Because those familiarities, those things, they reveal our old feelings, our old emotions, our hidden fears and resentment. And in 99% of all cases, it happens unconsciously. So let's talk how resentment affects our romantic relationship. Example number one, the inability to handle criticism from your partner. So when people criticize you, if you feel sad right away, if you feel angry, if you have any sharp emotion, it means that you are still playing the old game when your parents criticize you in your childhood. Second example, a fear of betrayal. If a child was abandoned by his father or mother, or maybe a child lived with emotionally unavailable parents. Emotionally unavailable means that your parents did not pay enough attention to you. They did not provide support. They did not love you enough. They did not value you enough. So then you have trust issues in your relationship. You cannot trust your partner. You cannot trust other people. And you have desire to control the situation, to control your partner, because you had this painful situation in your childhood when you experienced a fear of abandonment. So now you are afraid that your partner might abandon you or betray you. The next example, inability to meet a partner. When a person wants to find a soulmate, when a person wants to create a healthy relationship, but he can't. He can't find the person for that relationship. And the hidden algorithm of this situation is the fear of being hurt. So many years ago in his childhood, this person was hurt, and the fear of loneliness and the fear to be hurt again is so big, and it's unconscious. So I cannot find the partner. I cannot find the partner. I want to find the partner, but I can't, because I'm afraid that I will go through the pain again. Another example, perception of the partner as a small child. This happens often in the situations when a person had to grow up early. A child without a childhood, when a child was a parent for his parents, maybe his parents were alcoholics, or maybe they were sick, or maybe for any other reason a child had to take care of his parents when he was a little boy, little girl. Or maybe a child became a parent for a younger sibling. So a person learns to be an adult. And when this person finds a soulmate, finds a partner, this person, instead of creating trust, honest relationship, this person will try to control his partner and will try to become parent for his partner. He will treat his partner as a little baby, as a little child. And it's gonna screw up the relationship, because then he will diminish his partner, and it's gonna be parent-child relationship, not man and woman relationship. And the fifth example, a victim's role. The feelings that all bad things happens to me, and I cannot change anything, I cannot change the situation, I cannot change my boss, I will never find a good job, I will never find a good partner, I will never be able to solve conflicts in my family. So a person who put on a victim's role many, many years ago, when his parents were blaming him, was like, shame on you, how dare you, this is not nice, you should not do this, don't embarrass me. So when parents put a lot of shame, a lot of blame on small child, this child might grow up and wear a victim's role.